Happy day! Welcome to our ATC video today. At ang topic po natin ngayon ay SEC submission of your financial statement, required bang audited or hindi. Okay? So sa mga corporations yan, stock or non-stock corporations, and other business organizations which are required by the SEC to submit financial statements. So let's discuss first, yung ating financial statements ba na ipapasa sa SEC ay dapat bang audited or hindi? Required ba tayong ipa-audited sa independent auditor who must be a CPA or hindi? Okay? So, kami, corporation kami, we have two corporations, yung ating accounting tutorial center and our own new company, Pisces. So, last year, 2020, yung ating financial statement ng Pisces ay hindi audited. Pero yung financial statement ng ATC ay audited na ipinasa natin sa SEC. So, ngayon po pag-aralan natin, ano ba yung legal basis, when to audit, when audit of our financial statement is required and not required. Okay? So, ito po yung Securities and Exchange Commission logo. So, dito po tayo magpapasa ng ating reportorial requirement if you are corporation, ha? If you are corporation, stock or non-stock, because this is not applicable sa mga individual taxpayers who are sole proprietors or professionals na hindi naman naka-register sa SEC. Sa DTI kayo, di ba? Pero sa DTI, wala namang pinapasang reportorial requirements doon. Okay, we're talking of SEC, applicable to corporation, stock or non-stock, and other business organization, like foreign corporation. So, this is the legal basis for the submission of the audited or not audited financial statement to the Securities and Exchange Commission. This is revised 2019 Securities Regulation Code. Yan yung SRC rule natin na number 68. Dapat po meron kayong copy niyan if you are corporation, stock or non-stock. And ni-reiterate dito sa Memorandum Circular Number 2 Series of 2022 na ibinaba ng SEC, sino-sino yung mga business organization, corporation na required magpa-audit ng kanilang financial statement before submission to the Securities and Exchange Commission. Okay? So ito po yung ating Memorandum Circular. If you want a copy, you may request a copy on our Facebook page, Accounting Tutorial Center, or you may download this from the SEC website. Okay? So, ito po yung listahan. Ayan, ito yung listahan ng ating mga corporations, branch offices, regional operating headquarters of the foreign corporations na required magpa-audit. So, may threshold. So, itong pinag-uusapan natin ay audit threshold ng SEC. Magkaiba yung audit threshold sa BIR. So, may audit threshold si BIR, may audit threshold si SEC. Ito pang SEC lang to, or Securities and Exchange Commission, ha? So, basahin po natin. So, basahin mo natin yung number 7 ng page number 2. Page number 2, number 7. Sabi niya, the general financial reporting requirements as stated in the revised SRC rule. Ito yun, Securities Regulation Code Rule number 68, which was approved by the Commission and Bank on August 19, 2019, states the threshold for unaudited financial statements as follows. Letter A. Stock corporations with total assets or total liabilities of 600,000 pesos or more as prescribed under RCC and any of its subsequent revisions or such amount as may be subsequently prescribed. So itong sinasabi na 600,000 pesos ay applicable sa total assets and total liabilities ng isang stock corporations. So, tingnan niyo yung financial statements niyo na na-prepare niyo for the entire year o calendar year 2021. So, in total assets niya ba 600,000 pesos? Or yung total liabilities niya ba 600,000 pesos? if the total assets is 300,000 pesos, but the total liabilities is amounting to, magkano? Let's say, 600,000 pesos or 700,000 pesos, required pa rin magpo-audit yung isang corporation if that is in, if that is the case. Because, ang sinabi dito, or 600,000 pesos of your total assets or total liabilities. Even if hindi pumasok sa threshold ng 600,000 pesos in total assets, pero pumasok naman sa threshold yung total liabilities, required ka pa rin magpa-audit. This is the reason why our company Pisces for the calendar year 2020 is not required to audit our financial statements before submission of to the SEC. It's because yung ating total assets and total liabilities ay hindi pumasok doon sa threshold na 600,000 pesos. So, either total assets or total liabilities ang pumasok sa threshold natin, na audit threshold na 600,000 pesos, required na po kayo magpa-audit ng inyong financial statement before submission sa SEC. Ang ibig sabihin ng magpa-audit ng inyong financial statement, you must find an independent CPA who will audit your books of accounting records and who will issue a auditor's report and opinion dun sa inyong financial statement. Okay? Alam na po yan ng independent CPA, independent auditor. Letter B, non-stop. Corporations, pares lang din. Ang basihan ay total assets or total liabilities with the audit threshold of 600,000 pesos or more. Branch offices, representatives, offices of stock foreign corporations with assigned capital in the equivalent of 1 million pesos or more. Branch offices, representative offices of non-stock foreign corporations with total assets in the equivalent of 1 million pesos. Ito sa letter C, ang basihan ay assigned capital in the equivalent of 1 million pesos. Sa letter D naman ay total assets naman, hindi kasama yung liabilities of 1 million pesos. Letter E, regional operating headquarters of foreign corporations with total revenues in the equivalent of 1 million pesos or more. Ito naman sa letter E ay revenue ang pinag-usapan, 1 million pesos or more. And the financial statement of branch offices of foreign corporations licensed to do business in the Philippines with a commission shall comply with the requirement of this rule unless otherwise determined the commission as not applicable. And number 8, corporations which do not meet the threshold stated in item number 7 herein may submit their annual financial statements accompanied by a duly notarized treasurer's certification only rather than an auditor's report. So, kung hindi kayo required magpa-audit ng financial statement, ang ipapasa nyo ay financial statements lang. Annual financial statement, pero complete yung set ng financial statements natin. We have balance sheet, income statement, cash flow, equity, and notes to financial statement. Lima po yun, hindi dalawa, hindi tatlo. So, kung hindi kayo required magpa-audit, annual financial statements lang ipapasa nyo yung lima. Plus, treasurer certification. Okay? So, yung ating threshold natin para sa audit ng ating financial statements for before submission sa Securities and Exchange Commission, which is applicable only sa corporation, stock or non-stock, branch, and regional operating headquarters natin. Okay? Maliwanag po ba? So, if you have a questions regarding our topic today, please do not hesitate to contact us on our Facebook page or YouTube channel natin. However, our inquiries and questions, comments in our YouTube channel ay available lang po sa mga members only ng ating YouTube channel. Papaliwanag po namin mamaya. Okay? So, problem solved. So, before you submit your financial statement sa SEC, dapat po alamin nyo muna kung kayo ba required magpa-audit or hindi. Tingnan nyo lang po itong page number 3. Ng SEC Memorandum Circular Number 2, Series of 2022 para makita nyo yung listahan ng mga audit threshold. Dito kami pasok sa letter A. And yung ating company accounting tutorial center, malamang lagpas yung 600,000 yung ating assets. And malamang tayo ay required magpa-audit ng ating financial statement before submission sa SEC. Okay? Sa BIR naman, ang audit threshold ay 3 million pesos based on annual gross sales receipts. So, magkaiba ang audit threshold ng SEC sa BIR. Okay? So, problem solved. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat at iwasan na po natin yung iba't ibang penalties na hindi naman necessary sa ating business by educating ourselves. Wala na pong iba. And iwasan na po natin yung mga iba't ibang letters na pinapadala sa atin, lalo na ng BIR, by 100%, as much as possible, 100% compliance. However, how can we comply if we do not know in the first place? Tama? Hindi ka makakapag-comply kung hindi mo alam. Tsaka lalo, yung iba kasi na sinasabi, meron silang accountant, accounting firm, auditing firm, bookkeeper. Mas maganda na kasi may alam ka rin kasi wala. Kasi naman lahat pinapaubayan mo lang sa accountant mo, auditing firm, mas maganda na rin mayroong kang alam kaysa wala. Okay? And yung ating mga fear na nararamdaman sa conduct ng ating business, lalo na sa Bureau of Internal Revenue, mawawala po yan by educating ourselves. So mag-aral po tayo. If you're willing to learn, nandito po kami Accounting Tutorial Center para educate po kayo. Visit nyo lang po yung ating YouTube channel, Accounting Tutorial Center. And if you're watching us on our YouTube channel, please do not forget to subscribe now. Hit the notification bell for future updates po natin. At kung nagustuhan nyo po yung ating video, please paki-like na rin po and paki-share sa mga kilala nyong interesado rin matuto regarding sa mga topics na pinag-aaralan natin. Okay? And we would like to invite you to our ATC RWB memberships. So ito po yung ating Accounting Tutorial Center YouTube channel. Meron po tayong mga free ATC videos katulad nito and mga members only, exclusive members only videos in our YouTube channel. Okay? So kung mapapansin nyo, we have join button in our YouTube channel, or makikita nyo yung join button dito sa ating video na pinapanood ninyo. So para po yan sa membership natin sa ating Accounting Tutorial Center. So meron na po tayong membership. Meron po tayong membership ng Silver, Gold, and Diamond. So sa Silver po natin is 199 pesos. So 199 pesos lang po per month. Click nyo lang po yung join button at sa YouTube na po kayo magbabayad niyan. Mayroon niyang Paymaya and GCash and other payment options, debit card or credit card. So if you are a Silver member on our YouTube channel, you are entitled to our exclusive reply to your comments, questions, or inquiries on our YouTube channel and on our Facebook page, Accounting Tutorial Center. You may send your questions or inquiries on our YouTube on our Facebook page, Accounting Tutorial Center. Entitled na po kayo sa exclusive reply to your comments, questions, or inquiries. At kasi kung napapansin nyo, ito pa yung ating join button. Pag kinilik nyo pa yung join button, ito pa yung lalabas. Pili lang po yan, Silver, Gold, or Diamond. Ayun po, Silver, Gold, or Diamond. Kasi po yung mga, kung mapapansin nyo po, yung mga questions, inquiries on our YouTube channel, hindi po natin siya sinasagot kung hindi kayo members. Whether Silver, Gold, or Diamond. Makikita naman po namin kung member kayo kasi meron tayong badge. May badge po doon sa gilid ng pangalan nyo identifying you as a member on our YouTube channel. Okay? At the same time, if you want to become a member on our YouTube channel, whether Silver, Gold, or Diamond, you can show support to us now by making these helpful videos para sa inyong business. Okay? Sa Gold member naman, sa mga Gold members naman, we have 499 pesos per month. So sa mga Gold members natin, per month is 499 pesos. Entitled po kayo sa exclusive reply to your comments, questions, or inquiries on our YouTube channel and Facebook page. And exclusive access to our members-only videos. May mga exclusive members-only videos tayo on our YouTube channel. Diba kung napansin nyo? So ito yung YouTube channel natin, we have members-only. Mga exclusive members only videos na ang makaka-access lang, makakapanood lang ay mga Gold members and Diamond members. Hindi po siya available sa Silver members, para lang po yung sa Gold and Diamond members. Okay? If you want to access our exclusive contents, member only videos in our YouTube channel, magka-member po kayo ng Gold or Diamond. Okay? Pwede nyo naman po ito i-cancel anytime. Pa-member kayo ngayong buwan, next month po, pwede nyo po i-cancel. Okay? Diamond member po is 1,499 per month. Sa Diamond members po, entitled kayo sa exclusive reply to your comments, questions, or inquiries on our YouTube channel and Facebook page. Exclusive access to our members-only videos on our YouTube channel, mga very helpful na videos. And exclusive consultation like text, call, and email. So available po yan sa mga Diamond members natin. So, pwede nyo pong sabihin sa amin ano po yung pangalan nyo sa YouTube para ma-verify namin at our end. Kung kayo ba ay Diamond members, Gold or Diamond, or Gold or Silver. Okay? So if you don't want to be read by others your comments, questions or inquiries on our YouTube channel, pwede niyo pong i-send yung questions niyo or inquiries on our Facebook page, Accounting Tutorial Center. Tayo lang po makakabasa nun. Okay? Sa atin lang po yan. At the same time nga, you can now support our company, Accounting Tutorial Center, by becoming a member on our YouTube channel. Hit nyo lang po yung join button ng ating video today. Dito po sa pinapanood nyo, join button or join button on our YouTube channel. And piliin nyo lang po kung gusto nyo membership. We have Silver, Gold, and Diamond. Tapos ito po yung mga badge natin, may mga meaning badge tayo. May mga meaning badge po tayo identifying you as our legit members on our of our YouTube channel. Okay? At masasagutan po namin yung mga inquiries at saka comments nyo. And we would like to invite you, if you want to learn more of our RWB book, may mga RWB books po tayo. If you want to learn how to file and pay your own tax return, bookkeeping, financial statement, train law updates, and the tax audit, just in case you want to learn how to handle your own BIR tax audit, we have a hard copy RWB book with exclusive online ATC videos. So yung mga exclusive online videos ng ating RWB books ay different from exclusive videos in our YouTube channel. So yung ating mga videos ng ating RWB book ay sa Vimeo yun lang mapapanood, Vimeo. Vimeo lang po mapapanood yun, okay? Send lang po kayo ng inquiries on our YouTube channel, on our Facebook page for further details po. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. I hope marami po natutunan sa ating topic na, maikling topic na SEC Financial Statement Submission required pa ipa-audit or hindi. Maraming salamat po. Sa mga hindi pa po nakakakilala sa akin, my name is Mark Lord ng Bumagat, your RWB teacher, na lagi po nagsasabing, be educated po and you will be empowered. Maraming salamat po. Kita-kits po tayo sa mga other videos natin hanggang sa if you are willing to learn. Bye-bye!